Morgen.
Morgen.
Frisk.
Hej, velkommen til.
Tak skal du have.
Jeg en monster.
Tak skal du have. Den er god, den her. Nu venter vi lige på, at vi skal have noget instruktion her, for at vi kan komme med rundt og kigge. Så vi drikker lige lidt kaffe og...
Sådan en chokoladekiks.
Ja, og en chokoladekiks. Mm. Vi hygger.
So, okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna go quickly in the MGC, because they're gonna ride soon. So we begin by this one, then after we go to VRT, and then after we will finish by the MXGP and MX2, okay? Mm-hmm. Yeah, good.
Nu hørte vi lige lidt om... om hele konceptet. Det var sgu meget spændende. Ikke Emil? Det skal du huske. Når man har sådan en her på, så repræsenterer man altid et godt formål. En god maskine. Hvad er det, vi skal høre om nu? Nu skal vi over i 125. MX-125. 125, ja, som det også hedder på dansk. De er herovre. Det er noget Team MJC. De er ret gode, tror jeg. Vi skal vinde og se, hvordan de ser ud, de der.
Important to manage these classes because it's our future from Yamaha. So I work now 12 years from Yamaha, and I try to find my best to find the new talent, the new diamond. I'm really happy also to work with Yamaha because you can see all the riders start here. We can see the follow-up later. Today we are Maxime Renault in the MXGP, Thibaut Benistan, Rekel Zinga, Gris Ulis in MX2 World. Also Ivano Van Erp, Janis Vassulis in BRT.
Vi skal lige se på på factory cyklen her. Den er altså sej, den her.
Because you know it's a fine tuning between performance and reliability. Because as much performance you take or you put, as less sometimes reliability you have.
Absolutely.
But as you saw yesterday, Danny 18 with this one, he did the whole shot and he won the race. So.
De er ret seje, de her cykler her. Jeg vil nok sige, at det er nok det bedste udgangspunkt, hvis man skal starte et sted. Og som I lige hørte, alle de her gutter her, de starter altså hernede fra de her 125'ere, og så ellers bare arbejder sig vejen derop, hvis de er gode nok. Så får de lov at komme til at køre 2,5 bagefter, og så videre og så videre, ikke? Hvis de er rigtig gode. Så, nu skal I se her, mine damer og herrer. Nu går vi nemlig lige steppet videre, fordi nu skal vi så i deres MX 2,5, det vil sige, det er fire takter nu, ikke? Hvis man er god nok i deres 125-time, så rykker man herind. Og der har de Ivo van Erp, og de har en amerikansk gut, der hedder Gavin Towers, der kommer direkte fra The United States of Awesome.
Team is also a French team, two riders at the moment. So Gavin Towers, US guy, Ivano Van Erp, a Dutch guy. So Ivano is fourth in the championship, and Gavin is a bit behind, but he didn't begin the season with us. As I told you, he's coming from US and from Star Racing, and so it's good to have him on board also, because it's always interesting what I told you to share also the strategy.
Thank you, Alex, and welcome to everyone. Alex, so explain you a little bit the team. So of course it's so important to have a good team behind the boys, and this is what we try to really make, and I think we have super good and strong team with good atmosphere, and is a key to have and to reach most of success as possible. So.
Nå, mine damer og herrer, så blev vi færdige med at høre lidt om de her MX2 knaller. Men prøv lige at se her, det er lidt sjovt at notere, fordi affjedringen på de her, de er sådan mere eller mindre standard. Det er skridtet før factory, men det er altså næsten standard. Det vil ikke være tosset at få en aftale med de her gutter lige inden det næste skridt, som hedder MX2 i MXGP. Så der skal vi lige over og kigge nu, faktisk. Der er vi også lige blevet inviteret over. Nu skal vi videre over til the real deal, det vil sige, når man har klaret den her inde hos de her MX 2,5 gutter her, så kommer man altså videre, hvis man er god nok, til toppen af poppen. Nu skal vi have det her. Det er factory.
Here we are in the factory MX2 team. We begin to be on the top of the pyramid. So this is the first step of the top of the pyramid. Two riders at the moment, because of course Thibaut Benistan is injured. But we have Carlis Rezulis. So Carlis Rezulis is has just been promoted because initially he was in the MX 250, but due to all the injuries, etc. Carlis, we give an opportunity to Carlis to race in MX 2, and he's doing really well, and we are really positive and happy of the level of performance he's bringing to the team. So this bike is managed by Erjan. So Erjan is the team manager.
Vi har fået lidt at vide om de her MX2 cykler her. De her, de står altså klar til at give den gas i dag. Det her, det er Rik Elsinga. Der er altså ret mange fede detaljer på den her cykel her.
So here it's the bike of Calvin Blandoren, and here it's Andrea Bonacorsi, Italian rider. As I told you, we have two riders injured, Maxime Renault and Iago Gertz. So they will come back soon, but they had a big injury this year. So as I told you, a kind of a difficult season. Anyway, this team is coming. You know, last year we had a modification in the team. I was explaining to you that Total Metal team, the MX2 car, was before EMX 250, moving up to MX2. This team last year was in MX2, factory team, and they move up to MXGP. This team managed the world title in 21 with Maxime Renault through the 250 category. So, as I told you, here you have the racing mechanics. There is training mechanics also. After you have one team manager, Michele Lavetti, who is managing all the team. And then, of course, we have some logistic, we have some the suspension, electronic guys, etc., etc. So, you know, when this bike is starting or stopping, we have one guy who is plugging, deplugging to download information and try to make some modification through the ECU. And of course, this bike is a full factory one. So as you can see, it's a factory suspension. Everything is done especially for to have the best level of performance. We do have Calvin there. So this is typical, you know, the Yamaha philosophy. And Calvin was a semi-official rider in the past and so on. And we had a long talk together. We decided to give him the opportunity to jump on the factory bike. And honestly, he's deserving big time. He did a real good job. He's doing a real good job this year. And we are really proud of the job he's really doing, because when you have some riders injured like we have, you know, to have one pillar like this, it's key. And you will see that the speed is there, the style is there, and the overall position is there also.
And the bike
is there. So thanks Calvin, to be there.
Thank you, thank you.
If you have some question.
Is that a standard frame, or because we see some
Yeah, we are starting from the standard, but we are making some modification on it. You know, the riders are, we are making some modification, what we were saying, you know, implementing, improving, testing, trying. And then after, the riders is checking and say, no, this one is good, this one is less good, I prefer this one. But at the end, the riders is making his own setup of the bike. So we are trying to find a way, depending on their comments. And then following their comments, we are thinking to develop some parts on the bike to make them the more comfortable and the more performance possible. Here you have Andrea Bonacorsi. So he is our second factory rider. So Andrea last year was European champion, giving him the chance to jump to MX2 factory team. So he went in the factory team. Due to what I was explaining to you, injuries, Iago Gertz, Maxime Renault, we gave him, because as you see, he's a solid guy. On the 250 was a bit too strong, so on the 450 is better, and we gave him the opportunity to jump you know, managing the Yamaha philosophy. So, giving the chance, the opportunity to show, to demonstrate, and he's deserving a big time.
Thank you
very much.
Jamen det var det. Indenfor vi sluttede af herinde hos MXGP-teamet, hvor vi har Andrea Bonaccorsi og Calvin Flanderen til at køre som topgutterne. Og der har vi lige fået lidt at vide om deres motorcykler og hvordan de træner sammen og alt sådan noget. Det var altså ret fedt. Det var altså super sprøjt. Det er altså ikke lige værd, at man kan få lov at komme herind og bare lige kigge lidt på de her cykler her. Fordi de er full factory. Der er ikke noget på de her, der kan købes. Det var en fed måde lige at sige hej til alle de blå gutter herinde. Jeg håber også, at I synes, det har været fedt bare lige at komme ind bagved og kigge, hvordan det ser ud herinde. Og sådan et vaskeægte MXGP-team. Det kan et eller andet. Det er i hvert fald helt sikkert. Nu skal vi ud og se noget race, og vi håber da selvfølgelig, at de her gutter herinde, de vinder som minimum.